This is the SAP Developer News for December 5th, 2024.
There's a lot of talk about the integration of Microsoft Copilot and Joule here at UK ISAC. But if you want to try out and build your own customized AI use cases, then you should try our Generative AI Hub. We had a session on it on Sunday, where we actually used the orchestration service and the JavaScript SDK and the Python SDK to build our own AI use cases. And what I love most about the orchestration service is that you can use the same code base for all the available models that we have. And you just have to change the model name parameter to try out the different models and compare the results, which I think is awesome. We also have a lot of other features in the orchestration service, for example, the content filtering and the data masking, the prompt templating, and obviously the grounding feature, which you need if you want to build your own RAG use cases. And the grounding feature is already available in the API. In the next coming week, it's also going to be available via the SDKs. And I'm super excited to try it out myself. Let me know what you think once you tried it out.
SAP Build Apps updated its design time UI to put front and center the things that you use most often and to hide the things that you use less often or even just once during your project development. So the first thing they did is to update the main menu. So you have just the main parts of building an application, which is the UI, the variables, which I consider part of the logic, and connecting to data resources. Then they moved the preview and build, or now publish, buttons in the upper right in a place where most IDEs would put them. And finally, they created a much easier way to handle managing pages, creating new pages or navigating to those pages. And that way you don't have to go into the page UI. I've written a blog that gives a review of all the changes, some tips on using them or finding what you need though, and also my opinion on some of the features and perhaps some of the features I would like to see in the future. So check out the blog and I'll put the link in the description.
Hola, SAP developers. We're here at the UK ISAC Connect event in Birmingham, and I have some quick news to share with you. First, the integration architecture guide was recently updated. It is structured according to the concepts of the integration solution advisory methodology, and it provides you guidelines about all things integration, including process integration, event-driven integration, API integrations, data integration, and user integration. So make sure to check it out. Also, we want your feedback regarding the API management capability. There is a new survey available, and we want you to learn more about how you're implementing and benefiting from the capability, or even why you're not using API management. So we're looking forward to hearing back from you.
I've just got time for some news items on CAP and UI5. First, UI5. As some of you already may be aware, the Karma UI5 plugin is deprecated. This follows the deprecation of the Karma test runner itself, upon which the plugin is based. But don't despair, there are plenty of other testing options available, including the UI5 test runner. And also, there's an event next week on Thursday, the 12th of December, UI5ers Live, where this deprecation is discussed along with alternative options. And talking of next week, Thursday, the 12th of December, there's a second event that day for CAP developers. It's another CAP customer roundtable with lots of news and updates from the CAP team and discussion of topics from the community. That's you. So check out Oliver's blog post on the deprecation and also the event pages. Links, as always, are in the description.